I'm Lou Ann Hammond, drivingthenation.com. I'm here with Henrik Fisker, the CEO and founder of Fisker Automotive. Henrik, you're in production.
We are. We are very happy to show the first production car here that we just brought from the factory. So that's a big milestone, obviously, for a new car company. And we start deliveries next year in March.
In fact, you've come in under 3 years, which is sort of the standard range for a new car to be developed. How did you do that?
Well, you know, we have a very focused team, and we hired, I think, the best engineers from all over the world. We have now over 300 people here in Irvine, our headquarters, of course. And, of course, also we don't have the bureaucracy that a big car company has.
Now that you're in production, this is your first car, where do you go now from here?
Well, obviously, we have built up our dealer network, and our dealers are getting ready to start, you know, showing the cars in the showrooms in March and on after that. So we have about 45 dealerships here in the U.S., and we'll have about 50 in Europe and 20 in Asia. And then, of course, we start delivering of the first pre-sold 3,000 cars, which is going to also take quite a while until we have delivered all these. So we have enough to do.
Talk to me a little bit about the car behind you, maybe the horsepower, the torque, the miles per gallon, all that stuff, the price.
Well, we haven't finalized or haven't announced the exact pricing, but it will start at under $100,000.
Mm-hmm. And you get the $7,500 tax credit?
You get that on top of that, that's correct.
And the California credit as well?
When that is available as well.
Okay.
You know, that real advantage with this vehicle really is that it's the only luxury vehicle in the world that really is extremely environmental friendly. You can drive daily commute without using any gasoline at all. The first 50 miles is pure electric. And we don't have the engine connected to the wheels, so no matter how hard you step on an accelerator, the engine doesn't kick on until you're out of battery, unless you do it manually, move it into sport mode. Total range is still 300 miles, and we have over 400 horsepower in this vehicle, can do over 125 miles an hour, so it's a fast, luxurious car.
How are you going to market this in the United States?
As an electric vehicle with extended range, because really it always is driven electrically because we don't connect the gasoline engine to the wheels, and we expect that most people for a majority of the time will drive it electric, but I believe that range is freedom.
Right.
And that's really why we fell in love with the car, because it gave us freedom, the personal transportation. So the range extender is there to have that freedom. Whenever you want to go somewhere far, you can keep on going. You can drive from LA to New York in this car. You can't do that in a pure electric car.
Will you have the same problems with EPA because you are using a gasoline engine?
Well, I don't think either Chevy Volt or GM or we have problems with the EPA. I think it's more EPA that has the problems to figure out how do you rate this fuel economy. You know, in a car like the Karma, you can get all the way down to 30 miles a gallon if you abuse it and never plug it in. But you can also get hundreds of miles per gallon or actually just fill it up, the car up once a year. We have a software in there that will start the car automatically a couple of times a year for just a few minutes to run the gasoline engine. If you drive electric, that means you really would, you're able to drive this as a pure electric car except for a few minutes a year, where it will automatically just start to clean up the entire system. How do you actually, you know, rate that? Because an average, what is an average? You know, some people may drive only 20 miles a day, and that will be very different from somebody driving 100 miles. I think the range extender is, an electric vehicle with a range extender is really suited for pretty much 90% of all people. There'll still be the 10% of people who say, look, I drive 500 miles a day. All right, fine. A diesel is probably better. And there'll be people who says, I only drive 1 mile a day, and maybe a pure electric car is better for them.
EPA, ball's in your court. It's time to step up and understand this car. Henrik Fisker, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Brian. Thank you.